Welcome back to MJ Vlogs. Before we even get started into the video, I'm gonna need you guys to like, share, comment, subscribe, and turn on your post notification bells to join the family. Okay, so I'm sorry if you guys can't really see. I gotta glare my glasses from my computer. I was doing some work. I just decided to take a break and do a video. So the topic today is 5 ways to eliminate trust issues in a relationship. So put on your seatbelts, let's get ready, and let's get into these 5 things. So I had in my notes right here, and this is what I feel like worked for me. And I'm just let y'all know, I wouldn't say I'm stubborn, but I'm a person who, once I'm set in my ways, not really many people can change me. That's just the Aries trait. But I would say that growing, learning, and getting into newer and better things, changing my environments, eliminating people that mean me no good, things of that nature has caused me to, my nose running, y'all. It's too cold. Has caused me to change my perspectives and to actually give people a chance. So not only does this work in relationships, it works in friendships, business ships, whatever kind of ship you want, it work. Okay, so let's start with 1. Stop bringing up the past. And this one right here is for my ladies. Men do it too, but ladies, let's just stop. I feel like if we have questions about their past or their past relationships, don't throw them out 1 by 1. What you do, sis, is you think of all the questions you want answered. You write them down. I don't care if you write them, you put them in your notes, make flashcards, even write an essay on them. Get all your questions, all of your questions, and ask them at once. By you bringing them up multiple times, it's going to cause the man or the woman that you're into to like second guess you or look at you differently. And you don't want that because it makes your relationship go downhill. So stop bringing up the past. That's just key. 1, that's for you ladies. Men do it too. But ladies, I'm going to admit, I am a female, but I'm taking up for the men on this one. We like to bring up the past. Stop bringing up the past. Let it go. Ask all your questions you got at once. And then let that be that, unless he give you a reason to bring it back up. Now, other than that, fellas, just don't give us no reason. We won't bring it up no more. Baby, I can't spell. Hold on, y'all, because my phone playing with me. 2, live in the present. Referring back to 1, stop living in the past. Live in the present as far as like appreciate what you have now. And if he or she messes up and causes your trust issues to flare up, then you can take other routes on how to build that trust again. But live in the present, like stop allowing yourself to think back of what Keisha did or what Tyrone did. That's not Keisha, that's not Tyrone. Let this person present themselves to you how they really are and stop bringing up the old people who did things to you. That's another way for your relationship to go downhill. You got to learn how to live in the present. Let this person love you the way they want to love you. Let this person, if they make mistakes, let them make their mistakes. Don't let them make the mistakes that you already think in your mind that they're going to make. Let them make their own. 3 is know what you want in terms of a relationship. Which is also goes to 4, but I'm getting to 4 in a minute. But know what you want in terms of relationship. How do you want this relationship to go? Do you want to be in a relationship for what? A maximum of 3 years? Or do you want to get married? Do you want kids? Do you want this person to be, you know, the center of your life? Like, you just got to know what you want in terms of relationship. Do you want just a casual relationship, a platonic relationship? Do you want a sexual relationship? Do you want someone to love, hold, and grow old with? You have to know those things, because if you don't know it, how do they know it? And if they don't know it, it's going to lead to them, you know, messing up. And them messing up is going to lead to you gaining those trust issues again. So know what you want so they can know what they have to fulfill. And that's just that. Number four is set standards. Basically, just like number three, know what you want. Setting standards is you need to know what you will allow and what you won't allow. And also with setting standards, you also have to stand firm on those standards. If you want your man to have a Range Rover, if you want your man to have a 9-to-5 job working for somebody else, or you want him to have a 9-to-5 on his own business, you need to know that. Men, if you want a woman who drives a Mercedes, stand firm on that. You want her to, I don't know, but whatever you want her to do, make sure you stand firm on that. Not saying that a car should define what you want in a woman, but I'm just saying people have those type of standards. For me, I want somebody who's in school. I got that. I want somebody who wants to own their own business. I got that. Those things you have to stand. Is it raining that hard? I'm bad, y'all. You just have to stand firm on those things. And I went through talking to multiple people to realize what I needed. Not, I didn't be in a relationship with multiple people, but sorry, y'all. I had to go through multiple people through talking stages to realize what I wanted. And it's okay. That's okay. If you're in a relationship with multiple people, do you. That's what you have to do. It's your life. Don't let nobody dictate that. And that's just that. Know what you want. Oh, my eye twitching. Know what you want. Set those standards. And make sure everybody that you come in contact with meets those standards. And if they don't. Now, I'm not saying have standards that's just over the top. Like, you have to go to Ruth Chris all the time. Like, sis, women, you do this. Don't do it. And the last and final step is to let go of fear. I gotta have a ministering moment right now. Y'all, we let fear overtake our lives so many times that we lose opportunities all the time. We have to stop letting fear overtake us. Especially if you know God, and you know the wonderful things that he can do, fear should not have a place in your life, period. Yes, okay to be afraid, to try new things, to try, to just try new things and experience new experiences, but you have to realize that fear is going to stop and hold you bondage if you don't let that fear go. And not saying that a human can live a life with no fear. That's incorrect. But as long as you put fear and God in the same vicinity, you are okay. You can mess up. You can fear of what the next chapter of your life is going to be. You can fear what this person is going to bring in your life. But you have to know that God is going to guide that chapter. God is going to guide that person that's in your life. So put God first and fear second. And by that way, you'll be eliminating fear. That's all I'm saying. So, and this was just 5 quick ways of how to eliminate trust issues in relationships. If y'all want more topics like this or more videos like this, I will do them. But these are just things that worked for me and that is all working for me in my current relationship. I will also do a segment on something that's very similar. I won't say anything about that. But yes, use these. And you will see how your life just changes miraculously. I'm just going to go ahead and throw number 6 out there. This should have been number 1. It just slipped my mind. Gain a spiritual relationship with God. For anybody who don't believe in God or things like that, that's viewing this video or that's watching our channel, just know that here we talk about God freely. We don't have no restrictions. So if you are not into that, then I'm sorry, we just lost a subscriber, or that we we just can't help you when it comes to spirituality. But yeah, gain that spiritual relationship with God, and he will eliminate those things for you if you can't do them on your own. And I am a witness to this. I can testify for this one. He will eliminate things that you think that you could never eliminate from your life. But with that being said, I hope y'all all have a great day, and make sure you stay positive and just be a blessing to someone and even yourself.